Now, the third chemical reaction is of acids when acids react with base, they form salt and water. Already we have seen, so there is nothing much to explain in this. This reaction is known as neutralization reaction. Okay? So this is known as neutralization reaction. Now, this neutralization reaction, we have seen many examples. Let's take few more. For example, your NH3, which is a weak base, when combines with the strong acid, for example HCl, it is going to give you ammonium chloride, which is a salt. Clear? So I can, but in this there is no release of water, right? This is an exception, you have to remember. So there is no release of water. Take care. But we can take few more example. For example, you can say H2SO4, when they combine with, for example, MgOH twice. Okay? Any acid and any base you can take, and then you get MgSO4 plus 2H2O. So this is a particular example as per this convention, that is acid when react with base, they form salt and water. This is the reaction of ammonia in which there is no release of water. Okay? But this is a reversible reaction, you have to remember this. Okay? So now, whenever sulfuric acid or any acid is reacting with magnesium hydroxide, which is a base, a strong base, it will release a magnesium sulfate salt, and along with that water molecules are released. Clear? So I hope this is very, very clear to you. So let's move to the fourth reaction, which is again a new one, so an important one, right? Now the next reaction is your reaction of acids with metal carbonates or metal bicarbonates. Okay, so we'll see the first one. Okay, so basically when you say metal carbonate, so what are the examples you can just take in your mind? First, this is the fourth reaction, right? Fourth chemical property, that is acids when react with metal carbonate, what they are going to do, you know, when metal carbonate, they release or they form salt, then water and carbon dioxide. Take it. So three things are being formed whenever an acid react with a metal carbonate. So let's take the example. For example, acid such as HCl, when react with metal carbonate such as Na2CO3, what is going to happen? Okay, so I'll just balance along with writing the equation. There will be formation of NaCl, right? NaCl along with water molecule plus CO2 is released. Okay, so in this you'll find, now this is a balanced equation. In this you'll find ki ye ek acid hai, jisko hum bolenge hydrogen chloride. This is your sodium carbonate. I'll write it over here. This is your sodium carbonate. ठीक है, एंड व्हेन दे रिएक्ट दे फॉर्म योर कॉमन सॉल्ट व्हिच इज NaCl एंड अलोंग विद दैट देयर इज अ रिलीज ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. सिमिलर टू दिस इज द रिएक्शन बिटवीन एसिड्स व्हेन रिएक्ट विद मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट. मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट, सी व्हाट इज मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट. बाई एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंट्स द हाइड्रोजन, ठीक है. सो यू कैन से मेटल हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट और मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट, ठीक है. सो इन दिस ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू गेट सॉल्ट, वॉटर एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, क्लियर. सो दिस यू कैन लेबल द फिफ्थ केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ एसिड विथ मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट, सो आई टेक द सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम्पल, दैट इज HCl reacting with NaHCO3. So this is your metal bicarbonate. So whenever acid react with metal bicarbonate, it is definitely going to give rise or give release to NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. Now you can check the reaction whether it is balanced or not. So these are the two chemical properties which were new to you. But the common thing which is very important in both of these are, that is the release of carbon dioxide. So in both the reaction there is a release of carbon dioxide. So we'll mark it over here. Okay? So see, carbon dioxide, and here also there is a release of carbon dioxide. Okay? So a very important question related to these type of or these two type of reaction from this chapter is ki, for example, they will give ki an acid, that is your HCl, is reacting with NaHCO3 or whatever the base here it will be, whatever the metal carbonate or metal bicarbonate is given, then okay, after the reaction of these two there is a release of a gas. Predict the gas and give the test for it. So suppose they have said ki gas X is released. So identify X, and also along with that they will ask you to give the test for the same. So for this you have to remember a very simple test, and that is, I hope this is very clear, right? So I'll just write over here the test. For example, this is a test tube containing calcium oxide, okay? So calcium oxide or quicklime water, okay? Quicklime. So when we pass your CO2 over quicklime, what is going to happen? The reaction, that is quicklime getting combined with the carbon dioxide to form calcium carbonate, will be occurring. And this reaction shows the formation of calcium carbonate. So if there is a formation of calcium carbonate, this quicklime is going to get converted to milky white. And when the quicklime gets converted to milky white in color, it represents that the gas which has been released here is your carbon dioxide. So this is the test which you have to write. So how will you write the test? You will write that when carbon dioxide is passed over the quicklime, it is going to release, it is going to combine with quicklime forming calcium carbonate which is milky white in color. Hence the quicklime will turn milky white, and after some time this milky white color gets settled or precipitated, okay, because it is in powder format, so it will get settled after certain time, okay. That also can be a question, so for that I am giving you a simple explanation, right? So the very important question will come to identify the gas and give the test for this gas, which I have already given to you. So you have to remember the reaction so that you can easily identify the, you know, gas. Acha, if at all you do not remember, so at least remember the formulas, okay, of a particular substance, because in exam they never tell you ki HCl is getting reacted with NaHCO3. They are going to say hydrogen chloride will react with sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate to form so and so product. So you need to remember only the formulas. If you remember the formula, the reaction will be, with help of your practice, by regular practice, will be thorough to you. So it's a simple request for you to please make sure that you are revising and practicing the a number of equations which we are doing over here. Acha, what you can also do is you can take calcium carbonate over here. ठीक है, यू कैन टेक पोटेशियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट ओवर हियर, यू कैन टेक एन नंबर ऑफ यू नो डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स जस्ट टू चेक योर नॉलेज दैट वेदर यू आर एबल टू मेक द रिएक्शन और नॉट. ठीक है, एंड दैट विल हेल्प यू फॉर प्रैक्टिसिंग इट सो मच. राइट, सो इन दिस सेशन व्हाट वी हैव सीन फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शन एंड टू इम्पॉर्टेंट बोर्ड क्वेश्चंस, एंड दोज वर कि टेस्ट फॉर हाइड्रोजन एंड टेस्ट फॉर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड का टेस्ट इज स्टिल हियर, एंड हाइड्रोजन का टेस्ट व्हाट आई सेड कि ब्रिंग अ बर्निंग मैचस्टिक नियर द माउथ ऑफ द टेस्ट ट्यूब, इफ द गैस रिलीज्ड इज यू नो बर्निंग विद अ पॉपिंग साउंड दैट मींस दैट इज अ हाइड्रोजन गैस. एंड हियर फॉर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड व्हाट वी हैव सीन कि व्हेन वी पास दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड ओवर द क्विक लाइम, द क्विक लाइम शुड बी टर्न्ड मिल्की व्हाइट, देन द गैस इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस. Clear? And also what we have seen, the milky white color which is formed gets settled at the bottom of the test tube or precipitated out because it is a solid form, that is calcium carbonate is in powdery solid format, so it will get precipitated. Clear? So this was what we have seen in this session, that is the chemical properties, the five chemical properties of the acids. I hope it is very clear to you. In the next session, we are going to see the classification of acids. So there are few different types of classification, and that will be in the next session. So I hope you are clear with the topic or thorough with the topic. If you have any doubt, please ask. So we'll meet in the next session. Till then, bye bye.